Hi guys! So today we're doing a fun lipstick top 10 video. Now I know a lot of you enjoyed the top 10 videos, so I thought I'd do like my top 10 favorite lipstick shades. Now this is not really about the formulations, though I will be talking about them or prices or things like that. It's mainly the shades. Like I love the shades. Number one is the nude. Okay, so I was never a nude person, and I know this joke is old, and I don't mean nude as a nude, I mean nude like this. But recently I've actually started liking nude lipsticks. Like I kind of like to mix them sometimes with a bit of pink, because I feel like a lot of nudes on me look like I'm a bit sick, like that whiteness, and then this makes it just like bleh. But right now I'm liking this one. So this is from Etude House, and gonna put it on. So what I like about this, it's kind of like a brownie nude, but it's got some color. Like it's not a nude nude, and I feel like I've said nude a zillion times, but this is one of my current favorites. Also love the formulation. It lasts long, it's moist, it's not like drying. Like you can see, my lips don't feel like cracky, and I think it's matte-y, but it's not like that drying matte. Number two is my favorite fruit and my favorite color. It's called Cheeky Peach, and this is my current favorite color. Like I just love, love, love this. It's by Bobbi Brown, and it's just, look at it. Like really, really potent. What do you think? So this is the shade I was wearing on Diwali as well, and that's kind of where the obsession started. I really love the way it looks, and I feel like it's just a really lovely color. Like it's not a peach peach, not a pink pink, it's like a blend, and it goes with everything. Like this would look great with Indian outfits, it looks great with like anything. This is kind of matte, and your lips do slightly appear cracked when you apply it, but it's very moisturizing. It's not like drying at all. And I feel like this is like my shade. Like it brings out everything beautifully. Next up, we have something that is flat out fabulous. That's the shade. This is from MAC. Again, it's really dark, which is what I love. Like you guys know, I love to do like dark lips as well. And it's a really interesting dark. Ta-da! So this is like a nice poppy magenta, I'd say. So it's got like a really vibrant feel, and I feel like it's a nice dark. Like it's not in that brownie tone, it's a very like purpley pinky magenta-y color. But again, it's a really matte color, but not drying. It's hydrating, and I feel like your lips look really cool with this color. Like it makes them like thicker. Up next, we have Proven Innocent from Estee Lauder. Again, this is really that pretty girl, innocent image kind of shade. Nude, but pinky nude. So this for me is like that ultimate good girl color. Like it's like the pretty pink, and it's like when you don't want to go with like a big poppy pink, this is nice because it's matte, it's kind of different, like it's not glossy. Like it's a nice pale pink. Up next, we have this ombre lipstick from Estee Lauder. Now this is the only ombre lipstick I own, but I love, love, love it because, as I said, two shades, a lighter pink and a darker pink. Gives you a really interesting feel when you apply it. Also, like a lot of people like to do the half and half clearly, I like to kind of mix it up. Again, a really interesting darker pink. What I love about this lipstick is you can like play it up, play it down, because you have two shades to play with, and that's the best part. So it's not really like one, you can go lighter, you can go darker, you can actually have like two shades if you want to use it that way. So it's like a two-in-one lipstick, two for the price of one, even though it's expensive. But yeah, I really like this one. Up next, we have my favorite red. Now I don't do a lot of reds like often, but when I do, I love Cherry Pop from Clinique. It's not a red, it's like more of a darker red, which is why I love it. So what I love about this red is it's kind of like a maroony pinky red. It's not a red, and it's glossy, high shine, high gloss. And that's how I like my reds. Like, I like my red to be like a full, shiny, Christmassy red. Up next, we have another nude, which is kind of sexy from MAC. And yeah, it's just, again, a nudie nude. So again, this is matte, but hydrating, not drying. But it is a kind of more browny nude. Like, the first nude I showed you guys was more pinky. But what I love to do with this guy is actually I use it like this, as is, if you want to. Or I layer it with my Burt's Bees lip balm. So this gives it a bit of a more pinky tone, and again, it reduces the matteness because this is obviously shiny. So it gives it a different look. This is how I usually wear this. Up next, we have Stronger. That's what the shade is called. Again, it's very purpley, which is what I like. Like, I like pinky, berry, purpley shades. Okay, so this is definitely one of the most unique shades I have. It's like a purple, but a very berry purple, not like a purple. So it's dark, but it's still feminine and still different. Also, the Pure Color Envy Matte lipsticks from Estee Lauder, one of my favorite formulations. So this, it just glides on. It's so hydrating. I have a lot of shades in these. The reason I'm showing you guys this shade is because it's the most unique and one of my favorites. But this formulation is definitely one of my favorites. Okay, up next we have a really interesting lipstick that I've used a lot, clearly. This is the Art Stick from Bobbi Brown. It's the shade Papaya. I love this. It's like, you can see it's a very creamy formulation. Like, it's kind of like if you took your lipstick and you mashed it, that's what you would get. It's not a liquid lipstick, but it's like a cream, like a pasty cream. So this is definitely my favorite orange, as the name suggests, Papaya. And because it's in this cream formulation, it's just really potent. You can see the way it looks. It does have a grainy kind of feel, like you can see the lip lines and all of that. But the color is just one of my favorites. Again, potency, this lasts forever. And it doesn't dry your lips, which is what I love. I hate drying lipsticks. So, I mean, none of the lipsticks you will see in the top 10 are obviously drying, because I would not put them there. But I'm still going to say it's not drying. Really potent, different formulation. And yeah, I mean, I love this. The last one is a liquid lipstick. Now, I realize I've just put one liquid lipstick in this list, which is my Huda Beauty Mughal. You guys have seen this in a zillion videos, and I felt like I cannot not include this in my top 10 shades because I love this. But it is the only liquid lipstick. So let me know in the comments if you guys want me to do like a liquid version of this with this and 9 others. I can do that as well. Love this lipstick. It's one of my favorites. So this is one of the prettiest nudes, like in a liquid lipstick. You can layer it with other lipsticks. You can just wear it as is, wear it with Indian outfits, Western outfits. I feel like it's one of the most universal shades because it's like a pinky liquid nude, and it's perfect for the day, perfect for the night. I just love this. So guys, these are my top 10 shades. My arm is looking like a bit of a rainbow right now, but yeah, they are very pinky. They are very nudie, and they're very purpley. But yeah, I do like a lot of darker shades as well, but they're not like my favorite all-time favorites. Like, these would be my top 10 all-time favorite shades that I use a lot. Comment below, as I said, if you guys want me to do the liquid one, you can do that as well. And what else? Like, would you like to see top 10 mascaras maybe? So you guys know the drill. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, comment below, and let me know whatever I've asked you earlier. Check out my last video here, subscribe here. Mwah.